Good day everybody and welcome to Noob Gaming. We will be continuing onwards with our Shaman build. Now I am on my way to the... I am currently on my way to the college, but the ruined version of it. Oh yeah, now I remember. I have to first go to the past, then the ruined future, then back to the past. Okay, so let's make our way through Warren outskirts, then to the Imperial Warren, and then we'll be able to get into the Great College. Thorn Totem is OP as hell. I really like it. Something, I must say, something that I have realized with my previous stream playing the Shaman is that the Shaman scales via minion damage, the totems. Because it's got the, if you take a look at it, if I, let's go into skills, if you hover over it, you'll see it scales by minions, totems and attunements. Now, I never knew that it was scaled by minions, which completely threw me for a loop at the end of the video when I actually saw this the last time I streamed it. I was completely amazed because, you know, totems are totems. Like if you play Passive Exile, you will see that you get totem tabs, not minion. Oh, well, you get minion tabs as well, but your totems are completely different from your minions. And I went in with a Path of Exile mindset that it would be more or less the same, which it wasn't. So I'm glad that Lost Epoch is doing things a little bit differently, but I'm still completely surprised about it. Now, let's go M, ruined area, yeah, M, yes, ruined area, ruins of Waldron. Okay, let's get to the top. Level. I need to remember how I was scaling this. Imperial, Ivron, travel.
Okay.
Increase cold damage, increase lightning damage, increase physical damage. Double while you have a minion. I should have actually increased that as well. It's a concentrated, yeah. But I'm thinking of maybe respecing almost everything. But we will get to that now. Oh yeah. There's fire, there's ice. There's not really lightning on this one. Actually looks nice. Okay, no chests. Okay, let's quickly go to... That's not the ancient area. Council chambers. I'm gonna try something.
Greetings.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Oh, in the shaman tree over here. Okay. Well, that's actually fine because that increases minion spell damage. Okay. Let's go there. Okay, so from here onwards it's health. Okay, actually wait, let's respec everything.
Greetings.
And then we'll take it completely from there. The lightning and cold resistance I'm going to leave, because that's really going to help. Okay. So from here onwards, we're gonna go to there. We're gonna increase minion damage, percentage of portion of healing received by minions. This health restored. Then we go to Shaman, and from Shaman we go and there. The next skill we're gonna go into here. Elemental damage increase cost speed 20% chance. Increase minion spells and bows attacks deals increase 100% 6. Each 10% damage increase minion bow. Okay, so that's more for bow. So that's fine. Follow your feet. Okay, now that I have respec'd everything in my skill tree. Let's continue onwards. Sorry. complex, I have chance to shock.
Yes? God be with you.
Okay, thank you. Penetration! Cruel down, cruise damage. 1-1. Damage, armor. Active totem, increase my regen active. Increase the attack speed. Let's see. Oi! Rabbi, zoom in. Why not increase? That's good. Thank you. added in there. More in here because of spell damage. But it's fine.
What do you want?
Shaman. Now I'm getting tornado.
Impossible.
Now the question is, does tornado scale? Be made into a totem. Doesn't look like it, eh? Strength of air, cast speed, duration, double cast, tornado attached to you. Calling it quits for today. Thank you everybody for watching. Hope you all enjoyed it, and we will go ahead and stream again tonight, and we will stream tonight. We will be streaming the Forge Guard to continue on the quest line with the Forge Guard. So thank you very much everybody, have a wonderful day. Please follow, like, comment if you want. Otherwise, if you don't want it, that's also fine. So thanks for watching, have a wonderful day.